my black people. It's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
Warning. Stand by for countdown. Prepare audience for maximum impact. Full immersion begins in.
To achieve liberation. Like Angela Davis said, it's built into the system.
Nowadays I can't believe what's going on in front of me. I don't want to watch TV and find another casualty. I don't want to read the news. My heart's already black and blue. I'm putting on my combat boots, 'cause I got an attitude. Like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. 'Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. And don't you even ask me, when did I become such an angry black woman?
We can't successfully put an end to racial discrimination until we change the entire system.
We've been trying to keep the peace 50 years since Martin King. Some don't like me for who I am, but I love my melanin. Another future college grad sleeping in a body bag. Mother screaming out her lungs, she never gonna see her son. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. 'Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done.
It's not right. Just keep it going.
They see something that I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Up 7 easy. There's a reason why, after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody wanna get in a beef with Angel Snuff Nuff 7. But you don't take me seriously.
You can't touch this. touch this.
About control. My control. Control of what I say and control of what I do. And this time I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready? I am. 'Cause it's all about control. And I've got lots of it.
Don't get lost in heaven.
mine.
Who cares about that?
I love mine.
Peace forever and always, and welcome to another edition of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I'm the Mighty One, Angel Snub No 7. Peace to the deacons of reality. Glad to see you this afternoon. Had a little time. Had a little thought on my mind. Just wanted to put something out here. I'm just wondering. I'm just wondering. I want to talk about this young man, Brother Ben X. And I like Brother Ben X because I feel as though he's sincere. And it was the teachings of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan that caused something to awaken in him, like how Elijah Muhammad affected Malcolm X. In fact, there's a lot of things that inspire us. I'm very sure that watching James Brown inspire Michael Jackson, I'm very sure, like we said, Elijah Muhammad inspired Malcolm X, and sometimes our mother, our father inspire us, cause us to really strive to be something in life. And that's a good thing. How you doing there, brother? Black son in the house with us. So, you want to know something before I even really start talking about Brother Ben X? I want to thank everybody for joining us yesterday. And if you have not watched, check out our Soul Liberation Day from yesterday. I feel very good. Well, I'm a perfectionist. I didn't feel as though I really wanted to, I really pulled it off the way I really envisioned. But I think that we did a pretty good job. Soul Liberation Day. And that Soul Liberation Day, I was inspired early in the year. And there was a certain way that I wanted to present it. But then I had to wait for months and months and months, and how you was thinking about it prior, by the time December gets here, it's a little off. But I know that we did a pretty decent job. So I'm proud of it. I want to thank everybody for joining us and share Soul Liberation Day 2024. Free your mind. and the rest will follow. Okay, let's talk about real quick about our brother Ben. All right. I'm wondering why Brother Ben X is afraid of Angel Snub. I'm wondering why he avoids us. I know in the past, he's in the clouds. He would check out our commentary. He's in the clouds. Sometimes he will leave a comment in the chat room. And the thing about it, I don't know why he's afraid of us, why he won't talk to us, but he can talk to people like Young Pharaoh. And if you watch any of Young Pharaoh's material about the Nation of Islam, he's very nasty. He's very profane when talking about the Nation of Islam. Hold on a second. I'm going to have to move here. I got this. Hold on a second. All right. Due to circumstances beyond my control, I had this big old bus was in the way, and they couldn't get out. I had to move out so this bus could make this swing. I'm wondering why Brother Ben X is afraid of us. Because like I said, you have people like Young Pharaoh. And there's a lot of people like Young Pharaoh. They have no respect for the Nation of Islam at all. I mean, just nasty. Talking about the Nation of Islam. I mean, really out there. But he's willing to talk to people like that. What makes me want to bring this video up is I'm wondering, I mean, do my breath smell bad, or we don't dress good enough? I mean, why are you afraid to talk to us when we're not like that? We're not like that. Black Sign said, where I'm from, that term is called clout chasing. Oh, maybe that's it. Talking to us don't get the views. But Young Pharaoh gets the views. But he's very disrespectful and he's very nasty. And there's another guy. I don't know who he is. I just heard the name. Some guy called Whack 100 or something like that. 100 Whack. I don't know. Something like that. Anyway, I've seen many videos. These people are really, really nasty. And you have, what's his name? You have people like Brother Ben and that other brother, what's his name? I forgot what his name was. But they willing to talk to these guys. I guess it's clout chasing, just like Black Sign said. It's clout chasing. And then you really make yourself look really, really bad. Because first of all, you really don't know the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. You really don't know the history of the Nation of Islam. The only thing you know is you like Minister Farrakhan. And Minister Farrakhan give you his version, and you think that version is true. But when you come out in the real world, it's a lot of things that's missing. Now, I'm not a teacher. Well, I don't view myself as a teacher, but to a certain point, I guess I am to a certain point. because I walked in your shoes. These guys never was in the Nation of Islam. Most of these guys never met Minister Farrakhan, never talked to the man. They never been in the Nation. They never even been to a meeting. They don't know nothing. I'm not trying to convince you. I'm just going to try to be real with you, because there's a lot of things these new brothers just don't know. I wish there was somebody like me who could have told me some things, because if I knew what I knew now, I would never have joined Louis Farrakhan. I wanted to join Elijah Muhammad as a child. I didn't know who Louis Farrakhan was. I didn't know who Malcolm was. I didn't know who none of these ministers. The only one I knew was Elijah Muhammad, and that's who I wanted to get to be with. You don't know nothing about the Nation of Islam prior to Louis Farrakhan. So Louis Farrakhan is going to tell the story in a way that he benefits. Most people not going to tell you the truth, because if I tell the truth about myself, I'm going to have to give you the good side. I'm going to have to give you the bad side, because that's the reality of it. I cannot paint myself as Mr. Holy and Righteous, because I'm not. Farrakhan paints himself as holy and righteous, and he's not. It's very people. Most people have skeletons in their closet. They don't want to talk about those skeletons, because they're trying to paint a picture that they are holy and righteous. Louis Farrakhan is not holy and righteous, never been. And even some of these folks that looks good, the only reason why they're holy and righteous looking is because of those teachings, because they putting on this show. How you doing that rain relaxation? I was in the Nation of Islam and got used to death. Thought it was good for a black man. They have nothing to offer you but give them money. All the light-skinned officers had the positions. That's true. That's true. And Louis Farrakhan even talked about that. But his excuse was, don't worry about the light skin. It's the word. It's the teaching. It's the wisdom. Well, you have the same problem with white Jesus. Why do you have a problem with the symbol of white Jesus? It's just a symbol. But you tell black Christians, take the white Jesus off your wall. Well, you got light-skinned folks. Your God is light-skinned, a half, supposed to be a biracial, which there's no evidence that Master Farah Muhammad is a biracial. According to Elijah Muhammad's son, Wallace D. Muhammad was a white man. According to the law, to law enforcement, he was a white man. He never was recorded as some kind of biracial. And we know that he's a foreigner. Everything about the Nation of Islam is light skin. You talk all this blackity black stuff, but there's nothing black about you. And we see how Khalid Muhammad was treated. The only dark skin that was on the roster. We don't want to hear these truths. And I don't have to cuss you out. I don't have to get profane and nasty. But just like the brother said already in the chat room, Brother Blackside, you know, you looking for clout, but you looking bad because these guys, they punking you out. They calling your messenger a pedophile, Farrakhan a scamming a con artist. They really going in on you. and they punking you out. They making you look bad. There's no wisdom in that. Except clout chasing. And what do you get? You get embarrassed. You actually make Louis Farrakhan look bad. You actually make yourself look bad messing with these guys because their intention is not to try to learn anything. Their intention is to expose and show that they're smarter and intelligent. And if they are smarter and intelligent than you are, what are they doing? Young Farrah ain't accomplished a damn thing. I don't even know who this Whack 100. He sound wacky. I'm very sure he ain't accomplished nothing. What's his name with the big mouth? He's a superstar. Charleston White, whatever. I don't know who. All these guys pop out of nowhere. They want to show that they smarter and greater and better. And you sit around because you want some clout. Because they can get some views. You on their level. And you ain't really making yourself look bad. I don't want to make you look bad. But you should know some things. They're not going to help you. They're not going to teach you nothing. And those suckers, they're not going to come and mess with me. Because we have the vision. We have the way here. I wrote Young Pharaoh and some of these other guys. They don't want to mess with us. They're not real. It's all entertainment for them. It's all entertainment. Louis Farrakhan got y'all all wrapped up in Scientology. And it sounds good to you. Elijah Muhammad taught for over 40 years and didn't need the help of Scientology. What you need that for? And you never asked for proof of nothing. I don't care how honest a person is. You should still want to see proof. You should still want to see that contract. You don't never ask and hold your people accountable. You never do. You just take them on face value because you like them. They keep asking about what happened to the Million Man March money. And the only accounting that you can show is you. Who else outside of the Nation of Islam participated in keeping up with that money? That's just like when we expect the police to police itself. You need somebody outside of the police to check on the police. You can't expect me to keep an eye on myself. You need somebody else outside of me to watch me. So it don't make no difference how honest I am. And if I'm honest, I don't mind other people in my business because they ain't gonna find nothing. But if you don't want some outside sources to check the records, you might be trying to hide something. The Nation of Islam has never and is not offering outside sources to look at the records, where all this money, so we can squash this question once and for all. Because if you don't do that, you look suspicious and you look bad. But see, people who caught up in personality don't give a damn anyway. You don't give a damn if Farrakhan is stealing. You don't care because I like him. Matter of fact, I even heard people say, I don't care what they doing with the money. I like him. Because it's not about revolution. It's not about liberation. It's about likes. It's about views. It's about entertainment. It's about your emotion. He make me feel good. That's what it's about. So that's why you don't care. You don't care what these folks do because they are nothing but entertainment for you. You're not real. And that's why they don't like Angel Snuttin' Up 7. That's why they stay the hell away from me, because I know, you know that I know that you're not real. Nothing about this impressed me. I don't care about living in a big house, diamond rings, all this kind of stuff. I just want us to be for real liberated. I want us to be free. I don't care nothing about all that stuff. I've made enough money where I could come on video and show off diamond rings and some gold. I could afford a nice big ass house. I could do all that stuff if I wanted to. I'm not impressed. When you die, you can't take none of that. All these rich folks, you can't take none of that. You're not going to take the swimming pool with you. You're not going to take the 5 basketball courts with you. What's his name? Jamie Foxx. He claimed he just had a death scare. Ain't learned a damn thing. You would think if you're on your deathbed, you would look at life differently. He ain't learned a damn thing. Because all this don't mean nothing. When they put you in the ground, your big house is not going to cry for you. Your bank account is not going to cry for you. Your gold, your silver, your YouTube channel with your 300,000, 1 million subscribers don't mean nothing. You can't take none of that with you. The only thing you really have in this life is your reputation. What were you as a person? Were you trash? Was you ratchet? That's what you need to think about. Those things don't mean anything. The people that really care about you and shed tears for you and wishing that you was here. Not because you can sing and dance, because you was a good human being. Not because you was a millionaire. Not because you was the president of the United States, because that was a good person that we lost. We're not good people. We want to control and rule. For what? Because I'm better, I'm smarter. Why are y'all, I would like to ask Brother Ben, why do y'all rally around one man, a couple of people? Oh, it's Master Farah Muhammad, it's Louis Farrakhan, it's Elijah Muhammad. It's 40 million black people in this country. Why are we going to rally around 3 people? What kind of God only gives solution only to a little handful? What about us? Aren't you a child of God? Why only this special group means anything? John, Paul, George, and Ringo. What about all of you? When I talk from this platform, I'm not talking for me. I'm talking about us. If I'm special, we special. When you talk about the human body, the brain is very important. The heart is very important. But in order to have a body, you need all of it so that you can function. We're not functioning because we're not acting as a body. Because one part is better than another. Ain't no sucker better than me. You should never let nobody believe they're better than you are. You don't have to be falling up all behind these folks. The body can't function unless all the parts are together. You have the brain, but the brain don't mean nothing without a body. So you can't function. You can't do nothing without a body. So we're all scattered here. Because we're not acting as a body. Because we're making these people special. And they're not as special. They're not special like that. You keep putting yourself down. I wonder, Brother Ben is an incredible young man. But how much more incredible could he be once he decided to discover his real self? Because you put Farrakhan on this pedestal. In reality, Ben X could be far greater than Farrakhan. I can say I'm greater with all humility because I don't need God to function. I don't need Master Farah Muhammad. I don't need the spirit realm. I don't need a crutch. I'm not better than you, but I can function better than you. Because I'm not crippled. Some folks need a wheelchair. But if you don't need a wheelchair, you're not better than the person that's in a wheelchair. But you function. You can do things. Because you don't need a wheelchair. I don't need a wheelchair. We don't need these crutches. You should be able to function on your own. That's why when you cut off the head, the body falls. So all these people that's following something, what are they going to do when the head is gone? Look at Christianity. Because Jesus is not here. They all over the place. Because Jesus is the leader, Jesus is the focus, but Jesus is not here to tell nobody nothing, so everybody's all confusion. I'm a Catholic, I'm an Episcopalian, I'm a Protestant, and all this other stuff. Y'all all over the place. Elijah Muhammad is not here. You got this faction over here. You got this faction of Nation of Islam. Because when the head dies, the body falls. And you scatter. If you really want to have a decent conversation, if you really want to learn, this is the place to be. Unless you clout chasing. Unless you afraid to be converted. I'm not trying to convert nobody to nothing. There's nothing to convert to. You can't convert to reality. You came into reality. You was in reality when we was in our mother's womb. But once we came out of reality, which was our mother's womb, then we come into the lies. They take you from your mother's womb, put you in a basket, and took you to some water and baptized you in the name of Jesus. They take you to the school system and baptize you in lies. The church tell you lies. And your relatives tell you lies. As long as you are safe in your mother's womb, that's reality. When we come out the mama's womb, here come the lies. Here come the fairy tales, the deception. And since we are babies, We don't know. We don't remember what reality was. And we accept these lies as reality. We should be ashamed of ourselves. We know Santa Claus is not real. Still celebrate Santa Claus every December, Santa Claus. That's a lie, it's not real. I believe they still celebrate Columbus Day. And we know that's a lie. We just liars. We love lies. But I talked about my mother. I told her a lie. The lie made her happy. These lies make us happy. So somebody like me, get you upset because you enjoy your lies. But you're an adult. Need to grow up. You don't need Santa Claus. You don't need these beliefs. It's time to grow up. I could be wrong. That's something else you will never hear them say. I could be wrong. And if I'm wrong, Brother Ben, if I'm wrong, whoever the hell you are, come and teach us. We're open to your teachings. But you're not going to come here. You will type in the chat room, but you're not going to come face to face because you're going to deal with the interrogation. You're going to deal with the CSI. You're going to deal with the forensics. And you know you're not going to be able to deal with that. So I would suggest to you, stay over there with them folks that's emotional. And y'all cuss each other out, threaten each other, how you gonna kill each other, and all this other madness, because you're not real about nothing anyway. The soul train continues to go down the road, with or without you. And see, sometimes you do have to believe. Believe in something that's realistic. It's just like an avalanche. An avalanche starts off slow. Then it starts building momentum and it turns into this big crash. I'm going to stay on the right path because this is the right path. I'm going to stay faithful to this because I know without this, y'all done. You're done. If you don't do right by us, you're done. Because all that fantasy and fiction, fairy tales and feel-good stuff, that day is over. This is the age of information, which means this is the age of knowledge. The age of belief is over. Falling behind ancient, illiterate, ignorant-ass people. None of you can prove your spirits and your spooks and your vibrations and all this other garbage that y'all talk about. You can't prove none of it. Just some feel-good stuff. We talked about my own experience yesterday, Soul Liberation Day. While I'm talking to you, I'm carrying cancer, lymphoma, in my blood right now. And the doctors don't understand how are you walking? How are you talking? How is it possible? They don't know. But this is real. You don't have to go back 2,000 years ago, 5,000 years ago. Right here in your face, you saw it happening right in front of your eyes. I'm not taking no sea. I'm not eating no sea moss. I'm not a vegetarian. I said that just for black side. I'm not a damn vegetarian. And I got death running through my veins. And I'm walking, dancing around, explaining, how the hell am I functioning? You ought to see the doctors. You ought to see the doctors. You ought to see the doctor's face when we talking about this. My cancer doctor. I don't know. Blood work is normal. I got cancer, but besides the cancer, blood work is normal. They don't understand how the hell. So you tell me. When you talk about your miracles, you got to make some imaginary speculation. You can't prove a damn thing. My doctors can testify. The people around me can testify. My neighbors can testify. They saw me with that funky bags and stuff that I was wearing, and they saw. I don't have to make up no lies, fairy tales. Mine is real. Yours is speculation. Yours is circumstantial. Yours is I assume. You can't prove nothing. And those medical records, I'm not a doctor. The medical records is outside of myself. You can't prove nothing. And I'm telling you, and I say, that we, on this platform, we are your mercy. We are, Brother Ben, we are the true final call. You don't get on the soul train, you're done. I guarantee it. And it's not going to take that long either. You want to be silly? Like my mother said, a hard head make a soft ass. And I just sit back in the cut and keep laughing at you. I said, look at these damn fools. Kept telling them. Don't want to listen. Now they crying. Yes, I'm going to say, I told you so. I've been told you so since 2007. This nonsense ain't working. Because I done it, Brother Ben. I already been where you at. All these folks, I already been there, done that. I'm telling you, it don't work. Why your silly ass want to keep trying to do something that don't work? Because it sound good. Because it feel good. It's not going to take us nowhere. That's on you. A bunch of clowns, and then you pass your loser ass activity down to these children. That's why I tell the young people, stop listening to your elders, because your elders are spooky. Your elders are insane. Your elders live in a fantasy world. They don't live in reality. They don't live here with you. Ask them, if this is so good, what has it done for you in the last 50 years? Wait, my child. They're going to tell you to wait. How long we gotta wait? We just wait and wait and wait. And you accept that. Other people don't accept all that waiting stuff. We are here to pull the plug. If you claim you can do something, then do it. These folks claim they can do this, they can do, well, do it. Because you damn sure ain't done it in the last 50 years. You can't do it. And you keep feeding the nothing. But you expect to get something in return. When you gonna grow up? When we gonna grow up? Free your mind. It's incredible. And I can't even explain it. When your mind become free. Because I don't need nothing. Freedom means you're independent. I don't need Farrakhan. You do. I don't need Jesus. You do. When you're free, you don't need that. Look at the birds. Look at the animals around us. They don't run around. I need Farrakhan bird. I need Elijah Muhammad elephant. They don't do that. Because all of us are born free. You voluntarily put yourself into slavery. Because you need these suckers. They sleep. They take a dump. They're no better than you are. You don't need them. We are born into a world that already got everything for us. And they weren't part of it. Jesus wasn't there when you was born. Muhammad wasn't there when you was born. And Farrakhan and Tariq Nasheed and Sanetta and Tahaka Hakimbay. You put yourself on a slave plantation. And you want to get angry at Angel Snub Nub 7 because I got off the slave plantation. You get off the white man's slave plantation just to get on a Negro's slave plantation. You defeating the purpose because you're still a slave. And by the way, there were black slave owners. So I guess as long as you are on the plantation of a black man, that makes slavery all right. And above all, these people do not care nothing about us. Look how they live. If I drive a Mercedes, all of us gonna be driving a Mercedes. Otherwise, I don't need it. I'm perfectly happy in my little Hyundai. If you can't have two basketball courts, I don't need two basketball courts. I don't need that. We learn this from Caucasian people because that's how they live. But then you turn around and talk about the white man do this and the white and all things. You're just a hater. You just want to live and be like them. You're just a hater. A lot of this that's coming out here from this blackity black community when they talk about white folk, it's because they just hate us. Because when you give them the opportunity, they do the same thing. They're no different. They talk the same. They walk the same. What they say? If it walk like a duck, quack like a duck, it's a duck. That's why when your happy ass go to Africa, they call you the white man. Because if it walk like a duck, quack like a duck, it's a damn duck. You walk like a white man. That's all you know. You can talk all that blackity black. Put all kinds of braids in your hair. Put all the dashikis on. You can put on any costume you want. You still a dark European. That's all you know. That's all you ever know. That's nothing but a costume. Okay, let me get out of here.
says it's around your home. Send love to Brother Tyler Hubbard after all is said and done. Truth is, Angola, Louisiana, you're the one. We're here. I can't tell a man not to defend himself.
I'm Don Cornelius, and as always, in parting, we wish you love, peace.